Welcome back to Naval Action. Today I'm going to have a look at the Pavel, or the, I'm going to ruin this for all of my Russian viewers, the Svyatoy Pavel. The Pavel is an interesting ship. It's a second rate. I'm just going to put double charge in. I've got the new officer perks, and we want to do some extra damage. The Pavel's an interesting ship. She's a second rate. She sits really well between the Bologna and the Victory. Very strange gun layout. It has just two guns on these top decks here. 6-pounders, which is a bit weird. You can swap them for carronades. The bottom deck, however, has got the best cannons you can buy in the game. Should be interesting, myself and a Bologna versus a Pavel third rate and two Ingies. The bottom deck has the best guns you can buy in the game. It has the big 42-pounders, that's the same as the Victory. The second deck, it's wielding the same as the Victory again, the 24-pounders, so she's got some hammer. In saying that, obviously a couple of less on each side than the Victory has to keep her gun total down. The Pavel then has 6-pounders on the third deck effectively, and then rather obscurely on the quarter deck here at the back. There's just a couple of 6-pounders. It has no front guns, it has no chasers, which is a bit pesky. You'd have thought with a ship of this size, you could have afforded the carry weight of two more sets of guns, but anyway, evidently not. Now, what is she good for? Well, she really does sit almost statistically between the Bologna and the Victory. She basically does 20% more damage than the Bologna and about 20% less damage than the Victory. Has the same armour as far as thickness is concerned at 73 centimetres. I've got a live oak build here, so it's a little bit more. Although has considerably more health or structure than the Bologna, so she's got 9800 raw, that's without any planking or build strength on it, but you know, considerably less than the 11,000 odd that the Victory sails in at. We'll just give Mr. Busily a bit of a tickle as he comes by. So we're already docked down nicely in the water. And we should be able to get a good slap in here. So just let the guns come across. So a little bit fast now. I'll show you why in a minute, and I'll show you how to counter that. Oh, hello. We've got a ram coming. No! You muppet. So I'll turn these guns off over here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to turn off my top two decks. F1 and F2, turn off my top two decks. now you'd normally be worried about being boarded, but I've got the defender here, so he won't, this fellow won't be boarding me. And he's rigging shot while he's at it. Unfortunately, my backside is a little bit more open than I would have preferred. So by turning those decks off, they still reload. It's just that when I fire them, they won't fire. And the reason for that is they're very high up on the ship. Very high up on the ship. And in fact, these ones here that you can see there at the back, right at the back on the quarter deck, they fire so high, I think they're just meant to kill seagulls. That's the silly 6-pounders. So I'm trying to turn as fast as I can. Let's just bring my mainsail around a little bit. And I'm just trying to actually stay here with Denise because this is a 2-on-4. And I'm running double ball on this side. Now that really only works at close range. So I'm going to see if I can get this Ingi back inside me. And I'll focus a bit on this Ingi. With the 42-pounders on the bottom, that does mean that you've got this fantastic ability to penetrate from 500 metres out, The top guns are really only going to work at 250. By pressing the R to change your sector focus fire, you can easily measure 250. I'm going to go back to lock sector fire. This guy is healing quite badly, so I am actually going to open up my top sets of guns here. And, one random fire mode. That would probably explain that last volley. See that? Oh, absolutely. Look at that. That's an Ingian reload shot, baby. Isn't that pretty? And then I'm going to try and turn inside in there. So the Pavel is a Russian ship built just at the turn of the 19th century in 1794. And it was originally in the Black Sea Fleet, although it had most of its active service operating out of the Mediterranean. Here's these silly two ones. Look at these things. Had most of its work in the Mediterranean, where it was helping the Brits out, well, helping the Alliance out really against Nappy and his mates. I've lost my friend over there, he's going to go and get himself all sorts of trouble. Let's just see if I can slow down a bit and come round. Keeping my side, if you look here, I'm keeping my side down so I'm not showing the scary bit of my ship to the enemy. I'm now randomly clicking on the front of my ship as if I had chasers, which I don't. Now I'm going to accelerate again. I should be able to get another shot against this incoming wind. I'll just fire these in here first. Anyway, that's mysterious. And now I'm going to depower, flush my sails. Going over. And just get that back up. So the Pavel was actually Admiral Ushakov. Again, I apologise. Admiral Ushakov's flagship. I'm going to turn off that top deck because it screws up my aiming. It was short-ish. Actually, it was into the water like that. So I'm firing double and it's killing my range, and so my natural eye is wrong. So I'm actually going to change this side back to double. That's a ball right now. And Ushakov sailed it into the Mediterranean around 1798-99, and was involved in a lot of the action against the French-held islands in the Mediterranean. I don't know if you saw that ball bounce off, that was quite funny. And actually supported a lot of land, not so much invasions, but yeah, invasions, a lot of land work. If I get this right, you should see the benefit of this ship's ability to penetrate at range. You can put stuff through anything up to about an armour of 90 with this ship. So I'm going to leave him behind me. Where's the Ingi? He's amazingly hitting my backside from 200 kilometres away, but that's AI for you. You'll notice I'm not loading this side. There's no ships on this side. This allows my sailors to focus on getting these fellas loaded. And I'll see if I can wreck this other Ingerman hunt. Put my sails straight again. Yeah, so he sailed it into the fleet. They did a little bit of, there was a little bit of sea battles. They captured a French ship, the Leander, that was damaged. But they supported a lot of land invasions, Corfu, which is a beautiful place, by the way. I think if I was leaving Russia in winter, Corfu would be my first chosen destination. Depowering again to drop my nose. A little sighter. A little bit over, unbelievably. You can see, I haven't got double in at the moment. And you see the difference there between double. So there's double shot. So double shot significantly increases the damage you do, but it reduces the range and also the trajectory. So they sort of flop out. Oh, there goes my rudder. So urgent repair back. Got a 5-minute cooldown, but these ships are quite far behind me now. We can focus these two boys down and then come back to them. I think that's the plan. I don't mind going hull to hull with an Ingi. Showing a little bit of an angle as you're reloading. Try to show an angle. A lot more stuff will bounce by doing that. And then as you get close to reloaded, depower in this case, because we are very close, spin your sails round so that they're flush to the wind, and that will drop your boat into the water. I'd much prefer to be on the other side of this Ingi where I could wreck leaks into him. So keep on coming round, coming round, coming round, and at point blank range, which is what I almost am here, this should do some hurting. Wait for the waves to go past. Come on, waves. He's leaning a little bit now, giving some. Even have a bit of a laugh and fire my seagull killers. Just into one of there. That's nice. Turn that one back off because we hate it. F1 turns the top deck off. And now I'm going to angle away from him a little bit just to try and increase the effective thickness of my armour. He's coming into me, which is no good. Don't want that. Yeah, so they were in Corfu where they supported some land-based operations, took a couple of French ports. I'm going to turn around actually now and go and head towards my mate over there. How's he looking? Pretty good. There was a bit of argy-bargy at the time. Nelson was operating in the Mediterranean at this time. It's not too distant a time from Trafalgar. And Nelson was actually outranked by the Russian admiral at the time. The Brits kind of did everything they possibly could to give the Russians things to do that wouldn't interrupt what Nelson felt was his operation. And, oh, good grief, look at that, he's come right up my clacker. As has he. Oh, this is going to hurt. I'm going to get absolutely stone marmalized now. So that's bad, because that'll start costing the crew. Now, I can't. Look at that beautiful shot I'd have on them there, but I've not reloaded those guns yet, so well done, Jeheil. Yeah, so Nelson basically tried to keep him out of the fight so that he could exercise what he thought was his right, but Ushan outranked him. However, eventually he was pulled back into the Black Sea, and really after those 4 or 5 years in operation, we don't really know what happened to the good old Pavel. So Pavel incidentally means Paul in Russian, so effectively this ship is the St. Paul. Look how high that top deck fires, by the way. You can turn that deck off as well. So this isn't a bad idea with the top deck, so you test your range out now, that's a good hit. Use that guy to cover us, give him a shellacking. And then what I do is I turn on my second deck. Another little shot at him. And that's high. See how high that is? That's mental, isn't it? I'll depower a bit. There goes my rudder again. I need to start taking some ships out of the game, so I'm going to repower. These guys are all over my backside. Get this thing reloading. And I really need this guy to come in and help out a little bit. So St. Paul is the name of the ship in Russian, and I really like her. She moves so much better than a first rate. If you've ever sailed a Santi or a Vic, should be anyway. If you've ever sailed a Santi or a Vic, you'll know just how slow they are. The sort of car parks with sails and guns tied to them. Let's see if we can get this guy out of the game. So it's starting to get a bit scruffy for him. Ah, I've just rolled high there. I need all those to go in. And the stomach will turn through him if possible. Just slow down a wee bit. Yeah, so only after 4 or 5 years operating in the Mediterranean, that was the last we saw of the Pavel. We don't really know what happened to her. Knowing the Russians, they turned her into firewood. And well, that can't see her again. I'm taking on a little bit of water. So I have a steel toolbox on this, which gives me excellent repair capabilities. I'm just trying to slip inside this fellow. He's going to sink in a minute. Let's have a little look. No, I'm going to do completely opposite. I'm going to turn around. I'm going to let this reload over here. Shove him down and start reloading these boys. And we'll go and play with Ben Grog. Between me and Iron Hook, we'll go and play with Ben Grog. If you'll oblige. Nah, this bloody thing won't get out of the way. You see, my rudder's broke, so turning's horrid. Touches paintwork there, and we'll use Ben Grog to turn us round. Not Ben Grog, his matey here, but unfortunately, he's a pain, this fella. So I've been herded away from the battle here. Put my sails back to normal. We don't know what happened to the path. I know the Russians, they turned her into firewood. They did have a bit of a thing for doing that. Lost a gun off her back. I'm going to repair soon, but there's no need to repair quite yet. There's a leak below the water, you see there? See, yes, there's two in red. That's two below the waterline. But that ain't going to go down in a second, and then it'll be 3-on-2, and those odds are much nicer. My right side is the side I don't really want to share. Go after Heinrich Bennett, if you'll oblige. Just turn a bit further. So I'm probably taking water on. I'll be the leaks I've taken that have given me a bit of water. And I'm going to turn the top two decks off. Let's have a look at that. Even at an angle, not that shot from there. But again, you see, I have no turning capability here, even with the sails flushed. Oh, my rudder's out again, and I'll still be on cooldown. No, no. No, I'm in a bit of bother. Oh, no, I'm not. It's okay. I thought I'd accidentally used a repair to that happen. I really want to get on Heinrich, so let's slow down a bit and come round. Obliging me at the moment, and now I'm showing the side I don't really want to be showing as well, so I need to loop around. So what is the Pavel good at? Well, it's good enough to take into a ship of the line, a regional capital port battle, absolutely good enough for that sort of work. It's a great ship in a hardcore fleet that's going to go into some open world AI battles or even PvP. It's actually the fastest of the ship of the lines, quite considerably the fastest. It does almost a knot faster than the Victory. It's actually about the same speed as an Ingermanland, just 11.5 if you take it raw. So at 500 metres I can actually, if I'm brave enough, Top two. Let's have a little go at this fella, because I will penetrate from 500 metres. That whole bit looked like a whole bit, didn't it? There you go, there you go. That's a whole bit. So now I'm going to turn off these guns, and all I'm doing is I'm telling the sailors to come this side. We really need to get Heinrich down before Dennis sinks, otherwise this battle will not be even enough for us. Now, that's not good. I am going to be showing. I need to depower quickly. We do have some guns loaded on this side, but I am going to take a nasty broadside here. Nasty, nasty. So I've flattened myself as much as possible to get rid of the lean. Thankfully, he wasn't loaded. So let's get back over here. So again, I'll turn off my top two decks. Someone's on fire. That's a hull hit. Sorry, matey, but you're in the way a little bit. Eight hull hits, and here we go. Denise is, I don't know what Denise is doing, really. So, she's a great fleet warrior. Fantastic support for your bigger ship. There goes the rudder again. That's the third time my rudder's at magic. I am sort of showing my backside a bit, but anyway. We don't need the rudder. Rudder's for amateurs. So she's a great fleet warrior. Fine in your big battles. Probably what she's best for is, because the Pavel is a second rate, the nice thing with second rates is you get two durabilities with them, so it means you can run them with full mods. Your golden mods, your expensive mods. So by example, I'm running her now with golden hammocks, and that means I get an extra 12.5% crew. Now that's a lot in a big ship, because that's the other advantage of this ship. She runs with 800 crew, so add 12.5% to that, and before you know it, you're over 900 crew. Alright, time to turn around now, deal with this fella. I say turn around with my somewhat knackered rudder. Start playing with this fella over here. I've got extra charge in these guns. It's quite long range and it's a big ship. I think Ben Grog, he's in the other Pavel. 73 armour. Anyway, let's have a little go. Take your time, get them lined up. There we go. And now we're going to start working our way into this fella. So I'm going to turn these guns off over here again. I'm going to turn my rear guns off so I can have maximum sailors focusing. If you look down now at my gunnery, I've got more sailors than I need, 400 and something, so I can have my sailing at full smartness. Now Denise is going to sink soon, which we don't like. I really need to close on Ben, baby. So what I'll do is I'll get some more shots off on him. Let's use my sighter. Just short, so slightly above that sail line. Let's have a look. Leaning into the water, so this is perfect angle for me. Hull and crew. I don't know what that means. Things are a little bit high. That's nice, that's some more damage. Now we're finding with the bottom guns, they're a little bit lower in the water. So give that a little bit of a dip. And there's the penetration, such powerful guns. Max range on a big ship, this thing we're aiming at here, it's got 70 odd armour, and I really need to get the attention off Denise if I can. And this is a great angle on this ship here. Now my top guns, I'm not firing them because at this range they won't penetrate. The top guns, I probably need to be 250 metres out for that to matter. Now he's angled with me as I'm reloading, I don't really like that. See if I can get him to straighten up. That's good. Give this a check. Perfect. too soon. He's angling. I am firing charged shots, so they do have extra penetration. Normally they would bounce. And unfortunately... Oh, is he straightening up now? I think he might be. Denise has still got a little bit of armour left. That's important for me. I'm going to try and force him to straighten up here. No, he's not going to. He's not obliging. Means he's going to get another bloody stern rake on me. Now, normally I wouldn't fire like this, but because I've got my extra charge, they do extra penetration, so now I'm going to have to turn around as quickly as I can. I'll probably get my bloody rudder shot off again. Which, to be honest, it was kind of deserved. And I did. Urgent repair is up. We'll fire off our rears. These are big guns, by the way. They're 68-pound carronades. You're throwing a fridge out the back of your car, out the back of your ship. There goes that other Ingi to the bottom. I'm turning round now a little bit further out than I would have liked. I'm showing my nasty side to him. I don't like, but I'll get the repairs happening soon. Oh, that's bad. There goes matey boy. Need to reload on this side. Yeah, they're almost reloaded over there. As soon as they are, I'll turn those guns off. And time to get the lads repairing, I think. Guns off. Try and angle as much as we can. Look at the range this fella's firing. I can still hit me. We're donkey donking it. So I've got the guys repairing. I've got 900 and something crew on this baby because of my hammocks, which is great. Stay at an angle. Hopefully he's bouncing a few of those. Not overly sure I felt that bounce, but anyway. And now we're almost loaded. We're going to swing into him. All his ports are closed, which is what we want to hear. I'm going to flush my sails a bit to drop the heel on the ship and depower back to Australia. I'm actually going to turn on all guns. Ooh, all right, get rid of the message. Come on, mate. He's got a C here. Okay, fire everything. Have at you. Have at you, sir. Come on, we've got another couple to come. I'm just angling away again there. Keeping depower on so that my ship's lower in the water. I don't think many of these are bouncing. But you look at how much repairs I get off. I've got a steel toolbox and the survival handbooks. Both of them stack. They increase the amount of... they increase the speed of my repair. So I'm going to start turning back into him. I'm still staying depowered. I don't like showing my underbelly to him. I'm on the wrong side of him. Not much I can do about that. He's at 250 metres, so I know my top guns will do the do. And this should really hurt. I'm just waiting for my main guns to come online. There we go. And that's how I got this. Yeah. There we go. 32 hits. Too difficult measure. And as we move away from him... These things will penetrate at this range, only up 250 metres. So just move away. Put a bit of an angle on him. And that's my repairs finished, so you'll see how much that did. I mean, I was in a lot of trouble. Still could be, but I'll try and get this fella on my right-hand side. Still could be. So, the real benefit of this ship is the fact that it's got 800 crew, you stick golden hammocks on it, that's 900 and something crew. 900 and something crew basically means you can cap a Vic. So you put your gold marines on it, and that's 450 gold marines, which is just, you know, bazookas. So I'm coming in a bit faster now to try and get level with him. And if you cap a first rate, your reward is 350,000 gold at the moment. That might change over time, of course. But that's a lot of gold. So I'm depowering again. Using the front line, I'm ignoring my silly quarterdeck guns. He is one volley away from something, so we're going to pull away, we're going to undepower. Perhaps there's a word for that. I don't know. Repower. And start putting an angle on it again before he opens his gun ports. Come on, move. Let's have a look, see what sort of angle. We're not making much of an angle. He's turning with us, and mate, you boys shoving a few up my clacker. And we've got a bit of an angle. Still got 12 to come, but I'm going to line back up and get nice and close on these ones there. As soon as I get that side armor down, I'm turning out of here. And we'll let Davy Jones look after him. So if you cap with one of these, you can earn 350k a cap. Now, if you've got the gold marines, and say, oh, I've not finished them off, that's bad. And say boarding axes, grenades perhaps, something like that. Not boarding axes, sorry, boarding parties. If you've got that combination, you can absolutely wreck a victory. You open up with an attack, and then you flip to grenades. Fucking hell, there goes a little bit again. Pardon my English. You flip to grenades, and then as soon as you've gone into grenades, he will go into, sorry, you go into attack. I'm concentrating on one, not syncing me. Not doing a good job of it. So you open up with attack. He will go into grenades, typically, as an AI. Alright, get out of here, Jimmy. He will go into grenades as an AI. And once that's done, you flip to grenades yourself as he's gone into defense. So you go attack, he goes defense. You then flip into grenades at the last minute, and your grenades will absolutely marmalize him. Well, he's got a lot of health on that side. Okay, so how's this side going? We'll let the side reload and turn it off. Once you've done that, your grenades will wreck his defense. You then just brace if you have to, which you probably won't do if you put all of those mods on. You brace. And then you attack. Never attack into grenades. And then you just brace and defend if he runs an attack on you, and you'll take the Vic down in 4 or 5 turns. And that's with the we're using the grenades. If you don't have the grenades, you can do a similar thing with muskets. It's actually not quite as good, but you can do a similar thing with muskets. So what I'm doing is now I'm making sure this side of my ship is facing the enemy. I'm having to come through the wind to do that, but it'll be worth it because he'll come past me on keeling, showing his heel. Or not. That's a bit of a blow. He's straightened up. I can't afford him coming past on my other side. Ben should be sinking. He's got no armour. I've stripped his armour away. Once you strip their armour away, they should start to sink. So although I'm going backwards, I'm actually going to hold this line. Oh no, now he's going to come on the other side of me. Now I've got to quickly turn. This is a disaster. Quickly turn. Reverse rudder. Because I cannot afford to show my other side to this fella. One of my clannies the other night, he went out with his Golden Marines and his boarding Pavel. Get some barricades on it. Okay, so there goes the rudder again. That is the, what, the fifth time? Thankfully I've got my urgent repair back up. Almost in positive movement, come on. And we're turning. Unfortunately he's got a nicer wind than me now, so I'm keening out, leaning a little bit. Where's this other ship? Oh no, it's on my weak side. Oh, that's a problem. Now we have to turn. It's getting a little bit tenser than I would have liked. He is not sinking as much as I'd like him to. Once I get level with this guy, I'll be fine, but if he gets on my weak side, I'm in a lot of trouble. Disengage if he, look at him coming round, he knows which side to go on. Thankfully they're all bouncing at that angle. Of course he can out-turn me because he's got secret AI hacks. Even though we're reloading these, we may as well get some into him. I have, like I say, I have got to remove my weak side from his fire here. Alright, so even though I'm going to fire those next, I'm turning them off while these ones reload, just in case I need them. And I've got to present my good side to him again, which means I've got to go through the wind again, although at least this time I'm doing it with a bit of speed. And see, if this was PvP, I'd be shooting his sails out now, but it really doesn't affect the AI as much. I'll just stick a few into his rear there. A few into his sails, I'll turn that was deliberate. Turn the reloading on. These guys are almost up. Turn these guys off. And now we're going to play Ring of Roses. Sure with this fella. How's he looking? No, he's not looking good for him. Alright, straighten up. May as well play. I'll turn these two off while they're loading. Look at the height. Oh, the loop on that carronade, eh? I'm not sure they'll penetrate to this range. I think I'm outside 250. No, they're all bouncing off. There we go, there's Ben down. Alright, now we just need to play Ring of Roses. I'll turn charge off on these in a second. I just need to keep this side to him. Well, actually, server maintenance is probably going to bite me here. Alright. Big shot. Didn't see where it went. Still short. That seems too high. That just seems too high. Oh, what's going on there? I've got a bad sighter. Alright. Round into. You see, I hate this ring of roses with these things. Nothing else. I messed his sails up a little bit. Alright. So my second deck's coming on, but they really need to be at 250 metres, so I've just flicked it to 250 metres there. And you can see I'm just on the edge of 250. I'm going to put the ball in them. It loads quicker than the double charge. It was quite a tough battle, this, because it was four ships that all had good penetration. And I fought them more on the one side than I would have liked. He's in the wind at the moment. So this is my opportunity to close in on him while I reload. These guns are off. And the problem is I'm showing him a good angle right now. And then what I'm going to try and do is depower, flatten my ship out, turning the sails into the wind so they're not being pulled by the wind. Still showing an angle, so there's no damage happening to me there at all. Get my sector fire back on. Not ready yet. Hold, boys, hold. Hold. Fire over there. A lot of smacky smack smack. Now, what we need to do though is get the power up, because we do want to stay. He's still, none of his ports are open. You see here, 037. He's beginning to open now, but I'm also beginning to angle. So again, you're not seeing the damage happen to my ship. Trying to keep her down in the water while we're coming round. Keep her down. I'm going to have to come through the wind, which I don't really like. High, you see how it doesn't move back? I don't want to depower as I'm coming through the wind, so I'm just going to have to wait for that's better now. The wind's on the other side of me. Fortunately, I put fuel to the ocean. Bit of bad luck. Keep your eye, make sure that you're on positive speed. It's not letting me get what I would have wanted here, which is running hull to hull. And now, gotta be careful. At any moment I could go negative speed, and if that happens I'll have to flip my rudder to reverse rudder. But if he's gonna play, is he gonna crash into that ship now? So now it's him who's beginning to keel. The wind's blowing him over. Will I be able to defeat Aussie's greatest fear? Server maintenance gods. See now that my superior guns, the 42 pounders and the 24s, are beginning to turn this third rate into custard. Not to undo the sails there. But they are beginning to make a mess of this fella's hull. Shots. So let's keep on coming round, because we don't want to show him our good side. I don't like shooting AI in the bottom, because quite often you take their rudder out, and unlike me, they don't fix it quickly enough. So again, always keeping this side to him, where possible keeping an angle, and that's why I'm not taking damage. Before, when I was up against a Pavel, he could damage me at range. And because the guns are so powerful, even if you give them an angle, they can still cut you. And that's what we were seeing. Now I'm on his other side, so that's a bit annoying. I'm going to turn off my top two decks. I'll fire them separately. They're carronades. So because they're carronades, they fire at a different trajectory. We start making a bit of a mess of this side. Kill the seagulls with the carronades. Look at that, it's ridiculous. Turn them back off, bring these fellas back online. Let's start getting close now. I well out armor him, and if he wants to sail in line with me, he can. If you look, I'm keeling a little bit here again, so I will want to just bring a bit of angle into it. Oh, I was a bit slow doing it there. He actually clipped my nose. Bring a bit of angle into it. I've still got plenty of sailors for the guns, plenty of sailors for the sailing. Alright, now we line up again. And this guy, he's got, I reckon, three more broadsides and he'll be down with Davy Jones. So again, we bring our main guns, our 24s and 42s in line. I don't have Marines on this. I did a video a little while ago where I had Marines and everybody told me off for not demonstrating the ship properly, because of course the Marines do affect your ability to sail. Let's stick the carronades into him. I'm going to angle away a little bit. Not quickly enough, I'm not. So I took a lot of damage there. More damage than I should have. I noticed he's slowed down, so I'm going to depower and just bash through this now. I'm going to go hull to hull. I'm going to bash through it. My wood against your wood, third rate. No problem. Get rid of the silly carronade thingies. Fire off my 12 pounders. Oh, no, the 24s are online. And the big boys are online. I love these things. These are just mental. Boom! He will be eating in hell tonight. Taken a fair bit of damage, we've lost a few crew, but given the fact my AI was a clown and got himself sunk, barely fighting one-on-one, this guy is about to die, so that was all successful. So let's just recap. St. Paul, the Pavel, Russian flagship, from the Black Sea into the Mediterranean. Dead set in between a Bologna and a Vic. There's the new Buchentier coming out soon. It sounds like it's kind of a bit of an upgrade. We'll have to see where it's not as good. I would imagine, ooh, 11 loops, look at that. I would imagine speed, this is fast, this one at 11.5 knots. That's fast for the big ship. Again, with no mods, of course, and straight out of the box. A lot of people, you could choose to take these top decks off if you wanted to. I keep them on just when you're in close, it is more damage. So why not? Also good for healing to sails and stuff. But for these ships, I manage the carronades on and off, as you saw. I keep these things unloaded if I'm not using them. He's actually outrunning me at the moment, so let's fix that up. It's a great capping ship because it has over 900 crew if you've got golden hammocks and marines on when you are capping. Fake an attack when he goes in to defend. Absolutely marmalise him with grenades if you've got them. Muskets if you haven't. There we go. That's just a life, isn't it? And then brace, defend and attack as needs be. And that is the Pavel. 4 kills, fantastic. 806 hull shots. It's 100 broadsides, 200 broadsides. There you go, you got your money's worth out of that. Okay. If you get your hands on a Pavel, you can fit her out with yellow mods, because you don't have to be scared of losing all your good mods when there's a terrible incident and you sink and drown, which can make her as good if not better than the first rates, because the first rates being single durabilities, a lot of people don't like to put their powder monkeys or their steel toolboxes or their other lovelies on there, their other shinies on there. And I think, look at her through the water, isn't that a gorgeous sight? Especially with the skull sinking in the background. She does heal a bit, so look after your underbelly. The current version of the game, your bottom gets shot a lot, and your bottom isn't made of anything particularly strong. But you can see the heel there, where you can stick leaks in a left, right and centre. And the rudder's weak, as you saw. It's not that the rudder on this model's weak. You could actually go for a rudder as a module. I've gone with barricades, because for me she's a capping ship. And build strength, again, because she's a capping ship. I run with an extra pump if I'm not boarding, and steel toolbox and survival if I am boarding. Then it's and I have an improved magazine on, I should say, a quicker reload if I am boarding. Then it's just the standard stuff, your hammocks, your boarding crews. I like grenades, I think they're great at murdering defenders, and of course your marines. So there we go. I hope you enjoyed the video. Give us a like, give us a subscribe, and I will see you on the ocean. And I will catch you.